Welcome to the Listening to Smile podcast.
I'm Ian Morris.
And I'm Fallon Morningstar.
And today we're just going to do an intro about the mission and objectives with this podcast that we've started. Fallon is an FDNP, a functional diagnostics nutrition practitioner. It's a mouthful, it's a lot of... Yeah, FDNP. And it's a lot of really... It's a lot of points of facets of knowledge coming together to assist you with a holistic lifestyle. And that's in a sense what Listening to Smile is doing with the music side of things as well. And so we've merged these together under this platform of the podcast and a monthly magazine called Frequency Minded Magazine. And so Fallon and I are doing our due diligence and finding people from all over the globe that are focused on a holistic lifestyle, that are creative, that are innovative, that are really bringing to light the awakening that we all know needs to take place in the world today. So, Fallon, do you want to share a little bit about what got you started into this lifestyle and what your vision for the work that you're doing with the magazine and the podcast are focused on?
Yeah, absolutely. And I don't know if this is shown in the video here, but there is a line coming right down from the sky to here. So I think that's super beautiful and powerful. But if you don't see it, just never mind what I said. But how I got into this work was actually from my own metabolic chaos, as us FDNPs like to call it. And it really is a whole host of symptoms, which are definitely the last thing to occur in our health. So symptoms like irregular menstrual cycle, chronic fatigue, insomnia, very poor muscle recovery, lightheadedness with walking. I mean, it just continued to compound until it was almost like the lightheadedness with walking was one of the ones that I said, I need to get some help. And so at the time, the only thing I knew what to do was to see my family physician. So I made an appointment. We did a typical CBC, a metabolic profile of blood. Everything came back as normal. And I said, I think it's my hormones. You know, I had been on a contraceptive for about 10 years and just decided to stop that through listening to a podcast with Dr. Jolene Brighton, buying her book, learning about that. And so I said, I think it's my hormones, doc. And he didn't really know how to do a full hormone panel. And I just left with more questions than answers. So I then went to my gynecologist and I explained everything that was going on. The only language I knew was to explain my symptoms, right? And she had said, well, what other contraceptive would you like to be on? And at that time, I just wanted to be a natural menstrual flowing woman, right? So I didn't really appreciate her conversation. And I had been with her for 10 years as my gynecologist. So it was just a very disheartening experience both times from the Western medicine side. And so thankfully, I did have a friend that was in functional health. And so I knew somebody going through the testing. And I'm such a part of my mind is very science driven. And so I do have a master's in environmental engineering. And so that mindset is there. And so I said, I would love to see your data, you know, like, what are you doing once you see these results that you're going through? And so I ended up going through the same testing. I did a food sensitivity panel. I did a hormone test as well as a stool sample, and that gave me so much validation for the things I was going through, and it gave me direction to know how to heal that. I wasn't guessing and checking. I was actually testing to know I'm not crazy in the mind. There is things that are going on internally, and there's a roadmap here, right? And so there were a lot of lifestyle changes that had to happen. You know, I had thought I was a healthy person. I was, I competed in powerlifting. I was training as a bodybuilder. I thought I knew what holistic food or well, like healthy food was, right? But it completely shifted my mind around when these symptoms were happening, because it was almost like, well, I don't know what else there is until this, till the universe brought this opportunity my way. And it's almost like when we have those very dark periods in our life, it is the universe and spirit or whatever you're believing in, it's an opportunity for us, even though it feels very painful and we feel lost and hopeless. It's almost like, well, you're just being shifted in a completely different direction than what you had originally intended, and for good reason, right? Because I wouldn't be sitting here and doing this podcast even with Ian at this time. So whatever you're going through, just please keep going, be open to changes. Because at first, when I was making these lifestyle changes, it was recommended to meditate. And I was like, I am not doing that. There's no way. But when you hit a breaking point, it's almost like you will do anything to get a more parasympathetic and more regulated system to come back into alignment, back into homeostasis. So I loved the information I was being fed. I loved just within 2 weeks, I was feeling better. Within a month, I got my cycle back. It was a beautiful transformation. And so it's almost like this onion being peeled back to say, okay, well, now we have gotten rid of those initial symptoms. What is actually this root cause? Why is this happening? And so I ended up going through the certification of the same practitioner who he had that certification. So the functional diagnostic nutrition is what I went through. It was probably 6 months into my work with the practitioner that I said, I have to, this is what I want to do in life, right? So I completely shifted gears and went through the certification. And after that, I had started a business, and I had been a certified personal trainer at the time, still am. What else? I even expanded. The one thing I will admit, and it was still an issue, was this concept of nervous system regulation. And I was still having like persistent fatigue sometimes. It was almost like I was in that pattern of this this go, go, go mentality, this hyper achiever, right? And so you can take all the supplements, you can eat all the right foods, but if you are in a different mindset, or if you have trauma in your childhood or in your past that maybe you're just unconscious of, realistically, you're probably in this fight or flight pattern more often than not, right? And so we have to keep coming back to this concept of the nervous system, and probably in a future episode, we will definitely dive deeper into that. But wanted to mention that now, because the journey of getting that certification did not stop there. It expanded into different types of therapies, and one very pivotal one is called somatic experiencing. And so I've gone through some personal experiences with a practitioner in that realm. I've learned about it. I've read books about it. I've, had a lot of experience of how to do this, because it does start at a nervous system level. So I incorporate that now into my practice of learning, really teaching people the tools that they can bring out at any time if they feel dysregulated. Mm-hmm. So, one more thing I have to, I didn't realize that we were going to like go into this whole thing, but one more thing I think is important to mention is that it didn't even stop there, right? So you can see the progression of these doors opening just gradually and beautifully. So the FDN, and then the expansion of the somatic experiencing, and now the expansion of listening to smile, because I had originally heard of Ian on a podcast, Living in 4D with Paul Check. And so I had these beautiful comments coming back to me from the community of, you have such a calming voice, you know, you should be using that more. And I had never had those comments received before. So over the next 2 years, with those regularly coming in, it was almost like, okay, I think I should use my voice in some fashion. And I had been very much into meditation, you know, which comes to a shock to some people because I was very against it. But the idea was to have these live meditations, and in my mind, it popped up, oh, I just listened to this podcast episode with Ian Morris from Listening to Smile. That would be a beautiful and unique way to tie this together. And so I had then become a member with Listening to Smile. And since then, for, you know, about 2 years later, I have been just becoming more and more integral part of Listening to Smile, and as well as Ian and I in a relationship as well. So it's beautiful how the universe works. I know it's definitely challenging at times to see things that you just can't see, but that's a little bit about my story and why I'm here, because the whole mission is to help inspire people, to help bring us back to our heart, to our essence, and to why we're here. And that's why we're creating this podcast, to share that in hopes to inspire you as well.
Yeah. And I think this is a great segue to talk about the hero's journey. Like, everyone has their mission here. Everyone has their journey, but we can all use support, encouragement, and inspiration along the way. And that's really what we want this podcast to be, is stories like Fallon just shared of this evolution, this peeling of the onion that she's gone through and still is. And, you know, me as well, and all of the writers, all of the musicians and artists that we reach out to through the podcast, as well as the magazine, you know, they have similar stories as well. So being able to share perspectives and to share encouragement, support, and just inspiration is really the essence of why we want to do this work with the podcast and the Frequency Minded magazine each month. So basically, if you're seeing this, we're, you know, inviting you to subscribe to our Frequency Minded magazine. You can go to listeningtosmile.com/FMM. Or you can also find our podcast on the same Listening to Smile site. You'll see it in the menu. And we also have a YouTube channel, Listening to Smile Music, you know. So it's all things that you can navigate pretty easily to find us. And so we're calling out to you. If you have a story to share, if you have knowledge to share, if you have inspirational, you know, background or creations that you're wanting to share, we're, you know, inviting you to be a part of this community with us and to be a part of that lighthouse revolution. And what I mean by that is, you know, in Fallon's community, oftentimes she had a hard time finding people like herself, you know, with the same type of morals or ideals or just perspectives on health, on nutrition, on, you know, holistic lifestyles, or even music, art, and film. And I think a lot of us relate to that because we were put in these different places to be lighthouses, to shine light in the dark. And so, yeah, this is basically your invitation to be a part of that with us. And we hope that you will enjoy the journey with us. And thanks so much.